morning and welcome to Berks Home at Work in our community. My name is Anne Gilmer and I'm the Director of Volunteers. And with me today is my guest Anne Semmel. Anne is our Business Development Specialist.
Good morning. Good
morning, Anne. Thanks for joining me here.
Absolutely.
Today we're going to talk about our Volunteer Appreciation Luncheon, which is like one of the greatest days, you know, up at Berks Home. We really have a lot of fun that day. And it is our opportunity to gather our volunteers together and show them how much they mean to us and thank them for all that they do throughout the year. And so this year, our luncheon was about 2 weeks ago. And it was a really nice day, wasn't it?
It was a beautiful day. And yeah. So many volunteers were there, and I really think they enjoyed the...
They did, yeah. Yeah, we had a great turnout. I think we had about 125 volunteers that were able to make it. Of course, unfortunately, there's always a few that can't because they're working or some type of other issue. But so we had a great turnout for that, and something, like I said, that we really, the staff enjoys, and I have a lot of support from my coworkers, and so I appreciate that as well, and it really helps to make the day special. And you know, Annie, we start planning the luncheon like in January,
yes,
early January. First, we have to come up with a theme, and so this year our theme was Down on the Farm, and we actually have a lot of volunteers that do have a farming background. Some are still farmers. Others may have grown up on farms. And we have volunteer groups that are farm women groups and Grange groups that come in and do volunteer work at Berks Home. So it was special to a lot of the volunteers. They really could relate to that. And what we do is, and I'll have pictures in, is we decorate in that, you know, in a theme like that. So then, once we have the theme, we come up with the idea for the invitation and the address labels. And then I sit down with the director of dietary department and we plan the menu. And the dietary department always does an excellent job.
They absolutely do.
The food is always
fabulous.
So good.
Yes,
yeah, they do
good.
A great job. So we thank them always, too, for all their hard work and their great work. You know, we get a lot of compliments on the food. So, and then once that's done, then my staff and I look and research ideas for decorations to go with the theme. And so I'll start by showing some pictures of some of the things that we did for this year's luncheon. So we had some banners that were in the hallways, and this one was showing the theme, Down on the Farm. And then National Volunteer Week was the 15th through the 22nd of April. And we have banners, you know, thanking the volunteers for all that they do. And I don't know if you can make that poster out underneath there, but it says Berks Home Volunteers are Grade A, and it's on the eggs, you know. So we just kind of corny things like that.
Yeah, yeah, but that farm and then.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah.
And then we had our volunteers, our Blue Ribbon Winners was another little poster. And our volunteers are dear to us, of course, in reference to John Deere. Yeah, that's right, yeah. So we had that. And then this was the room. We took this before the luncheon, the day of the luncheon. And you can see that we have a little bit of a, you know, farm theme going on with the eggs as part of the numbering of the tables. And then we didn't have flower centerpieces. We had plant centerpieces, which like herbs and things like that, which was really cute. And then little farm, stickers or whatever you want to call it, that were posted in there. So it looked really cute. And a little bit of straw around. So, oh, and the podium, we had a few decorations on
in the barn.
Yeah, and then we had the welcome sign with the farm animals, and I don't know if you can see, but far back on the right is a rooster on the hors d'oeuvre table. And then our volunteer Barb Simpson, who decorates our windows year-round, seasonal and holidays and things like that, she was super and managed to find some items, and some people loaned items that had that farm theme so that the windows could be done to match the luncheon. And then you can see a little of the red on the bottom. We had like a siding that was looked like a barn, so that it looked, you know, like you were approaching a barn when you came into it.
Well, and I have to say, the windows are always done so beautifully, but with this particular theme, mm-hmm. the residents and family can really, really enjoy it, not just the volunteers who
right.
you know, we were honoring, but of course, the families that walk up and down the halls, and
right.
And for the residents that maybe, you know, they have a little bit of dementia, mm-hmm. But they see these kinds of things and they can relate to the back in the day. You
they
know?
Do.
And
they do. They'll say, oh, I remember this or I remember that.
So it's absolutely motivating for families as they have their loved
yes.
ones there, as well as all of us, because we enjoy seeing how nice the windows
exactly.
are done.
And a lot of residents did relate mm-hmm. to these windows and enjoyed them.
Neat.
So that made it, you know, that was just an extra special part of it all. And then, of course, we have the two windows. And I do have to say that Barbara's grandson was nice enough to donate
his tractors?
For decorative. Yes, those were his tractors.
Gave up his toys. That's
yeah,
nice.
So he let us borrow them for the luncheon, which was really sweet. Yeah, and then we have these seed packs that are hanging, you know, posted around. And when the luncheon was over, we gave the seed packs to the residents for their garden club. So hopefully they might get some plants out of them. So this is just
more of the
decor. And this little
really
farm
cute.
Set is an old set. You can see this roof lifts off mm-hmm. so that you can go in there and interact with that. So, and that was another thing that was donated for the display.
Oh,
and
yes.
then, yep, here are folks coming to the lawn. And there you are, Annie. You're in the back of this picture.
Oh, yep.
But this was when people were really just getting to their seats before things started. But we did, like I said, we had a full house, so it was really, it was a great day. Everybody enjoyed it, including us. And so people are just, you know, talking. And what's nice is that some of these volunteers don't really run into each other because their schedules are different for when they come in. So they get to see each other, and maybe some just meet for the first time and see what each other is doing.
Well, and they do
so
different
it's a great,
things, too.
Yes,
each
exactly.
Each have a different kind of thing that they like
right,
to do.
Right, their niche of what they're doing,
and,
yes.
And like you said, to bring them all together, mm-hmm. it is neat. It was a lot of chatter. The room
was
buzzing.
Yes,
with,
it was.
Laughter and fun. It was
yeah.
it was a nice day.
It really was, yeah. So, and we're just showing different angles here, different parts of the room and tables. So a lot of, now I guess, yeah, there some are having hors d'oeuvres, and then the
and
next
did. We
thing
had
that
great hors d'oeuvres mm-hmm. prior to cheese and
yes,
crackers.
Yes, the cheese and crackers, and they had, each year they have different things that are always enjoyable. And these three ladies, the Marion and her sister Hetty, Marion's on the far left and then Hetty's in the middle, and then Bonnie is next to her. The two, Hetty and Marion, are sisters who come and volunteer, but they volunteer on different days, you know. And then Bonnie is a friend of theirs who volunteers too, so
that's
that was
nice.
A nice shot of them all, yeah. So, and then the management staff is wait staff. They wear black and white, and they come in and they help out by serving the volunteers. Since the volunteers serve us all the time, we enjoy having the chance to reverse those roles. And that's our administrator who's pointing to something. He's got the microphone, so he's talking about things. But to his right is Dave Ruth, who's our director of security. He helped being part of the wait staff. And then on the left, next to me, is our director of nursing, Doris Logan. Mm-hmm. And then Suzanne Coutrelelis from the business office, Donna Murray from activities, and Joanne from ARNAC, Joanne Cummings. So they all helped to serve the volunteers. And then we have, starting on the right-hand side, is Rebecca from Social Services. There's Annie. Looks like you were in the middle.
With a terrible picture.
Well, sorry. I don't know if you're in the middle of saying something.
Probably.
And then next to Annie is Bobby Joe, the Administrator Secretary, and then Karen Fox from Admissions, too. So I had a lot of great help. And what's so nice is that everybody enjoys doing it. You know what I mean?
We really do. We really do.
I know that. And I mean, it shows, and the volunteers definitely get that vibe. And that's part of what makes the day so special, too, because everybody is enjoying themselves, you know. And I guess this
there
was
you
right
are,
before.
Talking.
Yeah, I think this is before, right before maybe Chaplain Hicks, who's on the far right, did the invocation. Oh, and then here's Bobby Joe on the right with Doris in the middle, and then Amy McKnight, which is an assistant director of nursing, that they posed for a picture. And you can see John Pauly in the background. He's our material management mm-hmm. director. He was also a big help.
Everybody was out.
Yeah,
you know, all
they
hands
were.
On deck for that couple hours of time. And
yes.
We really enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was nice. And then here's Larry, our director of dietary, and Katrina. And had just gotten the salads ready, and they're waiting on the trays to get served. Mm-hmm. And so now you can see all the staff that's out and about here, including our administrator, serving the salads to the volunteers and filling up drinks or refilling mm-hmm. drinks.
Iced tea.
And here you can see Commissioner Barnhart. He was there along with Commissioner Leinbach, and they both always have nice words to say to the volunteers. And we appreciate them coming out and supporting our volunteers. So, something there.
Yep.
And then
busy working.
Yeah. So here, Barb Simpson is in the middle here of the table. She wore denim and like a kerchief,
yeah,
you know, kind of
like
a little
the
in the theme.
Room.
Yeah. And that's the woman who decorates our windows, Barb Simpson, and her husband Alan next to her. Helps her to load and unload all the stuff that she takes in and out.
It's every season.
Yeah.
And you never know what she's going to put
exactly.
in the window, but it's always
right.
fabulous.
Right. It is always nice. So as you can see, we really did mm-hmm. have a full house.
Lots of pictures, lots of
lots of volunteers doing lots of different mm-hmm. things here. Yeah. And you can see all the staff working hard
yep.
to make it
yep.
nice for the
serving.
Volunteers. Yeah.
As you can see, there were quite a few people.
Yes,
like
there were. It was a very nice turnout. I want to have to point out Bob here, who's at the end of this table, and he wore bib overalls.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he is a farmer. And he wore bib overalls. He wanted to dress the part for the luncheon, which was really cute.
Yeah.
So, he's a funny guy. There he is,
there
too.
He
There's
is,
a little
yeah.
closer
yeah.
up shot of him. And there you can see Donna handing out the baskets of rolls.
Mm-hmm. Got a lot of good pictures, Anne.
Yeah. Carol took the pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, did a good job. Like I said, the volunteers get to mingle with each other, see people they haven't seen in a while, or sometimes
yep.
even meet new people. So this was another little decorated area saying our volunteers plant the seeds of love, and it was right behind our gift basket, our raffle prize table, which I'll show you here. We had quite a few very nice baskets and gift cards for our volunteers. There's another shot of them. And Annie, do you want to explain how we get these gift
Well, actually,
baskets?
At the beginning, all the volunteers come in. They each get a tag.
That's correct. They get
a ticket.
Yes.
A
mm-hmm.
number ticket, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's like their chance to try to win the
mm-hmm.
baskets. But
right.
prior to that, Anne announces to everyone exactly what's going on for the theme, et cetera, and lets all the departments know that, you know, again, voluntarily each department put together their own thought and came up with their own ideas for their different baskets. And mm-hmm. I think they're beautiful. I mean, they we had a lot beautiful. Of really nice...
Quite a variety
mm-hmm. of gift baskets as well as gift cards, which, you mm-hmm. know, sometimes... As we get a little bit older, we don't need so much stuff. We can sometimes use the gift card,
as a
gift to, you know, go to the grocery store
right.
or whatever.
Right. We had gift cards for grocery stores, mm-hmm. For gas, for restaurants.
Oh,
so they were really
yeah,
nice,
different
nice
variety.
Gift cards. Yeah.
But again, volunteers for. All of our departments are so important, and we know that. We mm-hmm. see that mm-hmm. on a daily basis, no matter if it's we in the admissions office or the nurses and social
Therapy.
Workers, everyone.
Mm-hmm.
I can't say enough good things about the volunteers. Berksheim's right. a fabulous place, but those volunteers really make it that much nicer
for the
residents that live there.
They play a very important mm-hmm. role
in
part of the Berksheim team.
But the baskets
true.
Are fabulous.
They
I mean,
are.
I just love the different
are.
Colored and the.
I don't know if you can see the one on the right there is in the metal. Bucket.
Mm-hmm. Oh, like the
it's a lottery basket.
Like the galvanized
yeah, it's galvanized.
Baskets.
And
yeah.
it was a lottery ticket basket. So I don't know where they got these prongs or whatever, but they had all these lottery tickets stuck throughout the basket.
Cute.
And they
yeah.
made two of those up.
Oh, nice.
And then I know we had a gardening thing basket. You can see here in the corner mm-hmm. we had some plants that were given away. We had like a s'mores basket with everything you'd need to make the s'mores
yeah.
over the fire, including mm-hmm. the prong forks
oh,
that you could
clever.
Use and everything. Yeah, there was a mixing bowl with breakfast items in it, and like I said, all the gift cards. So there really was a lot of nice prizes. And again, thank you so much to the staff at Berksheim, my coworkers, for making those contributions and showing our volunteers how much they mean to all of us. Now here's another shot showing some of the gift baskets. And then we have some of the, we always go out into the crowd and have a volunteer pick the number. And so this is just showing one of our volunteers who got a gift card. And here I presented this volunteer with a plant. And there she, Jerry,
aww.
She's so happy to have her gift card. I think it was to a restaurant.
Nice.
And there you can see Commissioner Leinbach is there,
mm-hmm.
sitting there. And this was also a restaurant gift card, and then I think some handmade soap. The girl makes
yes.
soap, and
yeah.
then she
put it with the gift
put
card.
That with
That's
the gift
nice.
Card, yeah. And here are our administrators putting down the basket. It's so big. He set it on the floor for the volunteer. That was the gardening basket, which was really neat. Or was that a snack basket? Well, it was a big basket, so it might have been the garden basket, yeah. Yeah, and then here's a nice basket that Ginny won. Another gift card. And you can see everybody who won
yeah.
has the big smiles on. There's one of the lottery baskets. They're all, you know, excited to get something. There's another gift card. There was a big, that might have been the s'mores basket
mm-hmm.
with all the things for that. Another plant winner. And here was a gift bowl thing. And this gentleman here played Santa Claus for us last year.
He
and
did
you can
a great
see
job.
He,
yeah.
he doesn't have to do a lot of
makeup.
Makeup to look the part.
Right,
yeah,
right.
so. And that's a nice basket. Yeah. That, I think, is the mm-hmm. gardening basket there. I see a knee pad thing. So, and that couple has been volunteering at Heimfest many years.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. We have a Heimfest in September.
Yeah.
That's always,
and speaking of Heimfest, this is the first time that we roll out the quilt for Heimfest, which, of course, is in September. But we have the tickets now, and we do start to sell tickets, and a lot of our volunteer groups will take tickets with them and, you know, go out to other members of their groups, other church members, their neighbors, things like that, you know, to sell the tickets. And you can also get them at Berksheim. But this is the queen-size quilt for this year's Heimfest. It's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
All shades of blues this year.
Mm-hmm.
And so we do display it at the luncheon so people can see what the quilt will be. And then there's a close-up of all the work.
It's,
I mean, it's
so
just gorgeous.
Pretty.
I mean, the vine here mm-hmm. at the leaves and everything, it's just...
They do a fabulous
job.
They
do. They really do. And then here, Evelyn was helping to sell tickets for those who might have just wanted to buy some individual tickets for themselves or, mm-hmm. you know, a friend or something. So we got that started, and that's always
and so,
an exciting
well,
part of Harnfest.
The highlight of Harnfest, mm-hmm. and then to find who wins.
It's yes, exciting. Yes. Everybody is always so excited when they win the quilt. So that's a good idea of our luncheon. Like I said, it was really a great day.
It was a fabulous day, and always good to be a part of it.
Yes.
As I said before, all the management and the staff are always more than welcome, willing to
yes,
be out there
absolutely,
and do
yes.
and to help. So
yes,
we are happy
so
about
it's very
that.
Very uplifting. Yeah, yeah, it's a great day. And so, as you saw, we do have a lot of volunteers, and not all of our volunteers could make it to the luncheon. However, we are always in need of more volunteers. You know, volunteers are something you just can't get enough of.
And why don't you tell them, like, how you can become a volunteer?
Right. It's really quite simple. It's not a long, drawn-out process. It's we have a brief application, a one-page application, and then we do have a HIPAA paper that you sign. Mm-hmm. We would schedule a time that I can meet with you. We can talk about the different volunteer opportunities and what you think you might like to do. And it's also important to know that, you know, we need volunteers 7 days a week. We need them in the mornings, afternoons, and evenings. So, and on the weekends too. So we are very flexible to work with you and your schedule. You can more or less see what's available. We always have a monthly volunteer calendar showing you what's going on. And, we would discuss that, as well as we have guidelines and things. We have a volunteer handbook, which mm-hmm. you would get, and mm-hmm. then you can go through that. And if you have additional questions, you know, I would gladly answer that for you. If you've never seen the facility, we take a tour, and I show you where things are located. And some of the opportunities that are available, especially now with the nice weather, we always have the one-on-one visit opportunity, and we have a list of residents who have requested a visitor. So when you come in, you don't have to try and guess who might like a visitor. We give you some names, uh-huh. and you can go and visit with the people.
Oh, and that's nice, especially
and
like
it
you
is.
Said, if it's nice,
yes.
to, you know, the staff is so busy on the floors.
Exactly.
But to be able to take someone outside and
yeah,
just
at this
get some
time
air
of year,
and
yes.
know it's safe for them to be out, you know, as long
right.
as that volunteer feels comfortable doing that.
Right, but right.
It, so. The grounds are so beautiful.
They are, really and we have several courtyards. Mm-hmm. And even outside of our main entrance, we have benches and things. And so we have some shady spots and things like that. So to get some of the residents outside for a visit, mm-hmm. and it doesn't have to be long, you know, 15 minutes,
yeah.
something like that.
And
it just means so much for
and
them.
I was just going to say,
they enjoy
that's all
it so much.
For the folks to,
absolutely.
To have a little
yeah.
time to talk to somebody just to,
right.
you know. For
and we have so many things going on, like in the auditorium and in the chapel, that we always need volunteer transporters, which right. Just what that means is taking the residents from their unit to the auditorium or to the chapel so that they can attend these events, whether it would be worship services in the chapel.
Basically pushing a wheelchair. You
right.
know, it's not like you have to do any kind of
right.
lifting of
no,
the
no.
resident or
no,
anything,
you don't
like,
do anything
that.
Like that.
It's just a matter of pushing the wheelchair.
Right. So I know
so
a lot of people.
You can do.
Yeah, and a lot of people who worship service means a lot to mm-hmm. them. They want to be able to do what they can so that residents can also have that experience.
Right.
Then, of course, we have musical programs and bingo games, and we have clubs like the Gentlemen's Club and the Red Hats mm-hmm. Club. And all of those things, we need assistance in getting the residents to those events. You can also help on a unit, and if you like to do crafts, you can help with crafts. You know, you can assist when they're having a birthday party and help to serve food and things like that.
Really, it's a very
so,
meaningful thing to do.
It is.
You know, and you don't have to give a day, you know, yeah. an hour here, no,
that's
an hour there.
The thing,
something
yeah.
that,
you can once a week, mm-hmm. once a month, you
yeah,
know, you
whatever.
We set it up to what works for
what
you.
Works for you.
Because any amount of time is so helpful.
Exactly.
So if you would like to do some volunteering, if you're a student and have school requirements, please call Berksheim at 610-376-4841 and just tell the operator you'd like to talk about volunteering and they'll connect me with you. And we could set up an appointment or time to meet and talk about volunteer opportunities. Like Annie said, it's very meaningful for the residents, and it's a very meaningful experience for volunteers too. So keep that in mind, and I would look forward to hearing from you. And
okay.
Yeah, so that's done. Yes, I think that's exactly. I think we're just about finished. So, and I do thank all of our current volunteers for everything they do, and hope to meet some new volunteers as well.
And then we'll see you next time.
Yes.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.